At Edwin Watts Golf Shops by Worldwide Golf, there's something that binds us all. The collective goal to transcend the ordinary. Introducing the Ping G430 Max 10K driver. Straighter flies farther with Ping's most forgiving driver ever made, the Max 10K. Come in today and test drive Ping's newest driver at Edwin Watts Golf Shops. Visit us at your local Edwin Watts Golf Shops or shop us online at worldwidegolf.com. Get there.
Hey, it's Tina from Josh Cohen and the Home Team. It's time to freshen up your wardrobe at the Gardens Mall. They recently opened up a lot of new stores, including Nike, Southern Tide, Eli Tahari, Vuori, and more. So no matter what you're looking for, I can tell you that the Gardens Mall has something for everyone. Visit thegardensmall.com for their full retail and restaurant lineup and upcoming happenings. The Gardens Mall, the premier shopping destination in Palm Beach County.
What sets International Diamond Center apart from those big box jewelry chain stores?
The problem with big chain stores is that they're all run by corporate.
IDC owner Keith LeClaire.
That means the people at the store level just plain don't care much.
At IDC, you're not dealing with a bunch of retail clerks. You're working with a true jewelry professional who's not on commission and not beholden to a bunch of corporate dictated rules and policies.
When you're in the big corporate world, everybody operates out of a manual or a big book of rules. At IDC, we don't have a manual telling our people how to deal with customers. We empower our people to take care of those customers in the way they would want to be taken care of.
Get the respect, guidance, professionalism, and genuine care you deserve from people who put you first.
We tell them point blank, do whatever it takes to make the customer happy, period.
International Diamond Center, locally owned, internationally connected.
We want them to take care of you, protect you, and make it the best experience that you could possibly have.
International Diamond Center, US 1 and PSL Boulevard, and always at shopidc.com.
Does your business leave a lasting impression? Attractive, eye-catching signs help you stand out from the crowd and create a strong brand identity. Our team at Signarama West Palm are experts in helping your business get noticed and get effective signage in front of your potential customers. Our team can turn your blank windows or plain vehicles into money-making branding machines by drawing customers' attention to your business. So if you're looking to leave that lasting impression, call us 561-687-7993 or visit signaramawpb.com.
Sometimes it feels like the natural world is a world away, but protecting wildlife and wild places is easier than you think. At Palm Beach Zoo and Conservation Society, every visit saves wildlife. From preserving Florida's coral reef to creating safe spaces for our Florida panthers, we can make a real difference. Visit today to save wildlife and wild places at Palm Beach Zoo and Conservation Society. Purchase tickets at palmbeachzoo.org. Palm Beach Zoo and Conservation Society, where every visit saves wildlife.
Anajar Levine Accident Attorneys, call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
Let's dance. The college basketball tournament is officially here, and ESPN 106.3 is your home for all the action. Presented by PNC Bank. PNC Bank is committed to making a difference in the lives of the customers they serve in the South Florida community. See how at PNC.com. Also brought to you by Hard Rock Bet, the Cognizant Classic in the Palm Beaches, Ed Morse Automotive Group, Twin Peaks, South Florida Ford, and the Breakers Palm Beach.
Looking for the perfect pre-owned Land Rover? Visit LandRoverPalmBeach.com and shop for the finest collection of Land Rover certified vehicles in Florida. Every certified pre-owned Land Rover vehicle is subjected to a rigorous 165-point inspection and is protected by up to either a 1-year unlimited miles or 2 years 100,000 miles limited warranty and complimentary roadside assistance. Take advantage of 3.9% financing for up to 24 months on select Land Rover models. Call 561-209-7000 for more details today. LandRoverPalmBeach.com.
Hey, it's Dean Thomas. If you are serious about a career in golf, check out the College of Golf at Keiser University. Enroll in Keiser's Golf Management Program and get your degree from the best in the business. 3 PGA Master Professionals and an LPGA Hall of Famer on staff. You can earn your degree on campus or online in just 16 months. Scholarships and financial aid are available. Take your swing at a rewarding career in golf at Keiser University. More info at collegeofgolf.keiseruniversity.edu.
What's up, Heat fans? This is Jason Jackson from your Miami Heat audio experience. ESPN West Palm has you covered. Make sure you are always locked in with your favorite station to catch every single Heat game with me and the gang. It's time to ball, yo.
F45 Track, hosted by F45 Training Wellington and West Palm Beach, is a free 45-minute outdoor workout happening Saturday, April 13th at Palm Beach Central High School at 8 a.m. Get your morning workout in, meet new friends, and try some goodies from local vendors, including Cold Plunge Florida, Ideal Nutrition, and more. Must be 16 and over to participate. For more information or to sign up, visit F45 West Palm Beach's Instagram page. F45, team training, life-changing.
You're listening to ESPN 106.3, presented by Rubenstein Law. 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Car accident, truck accident, Uber or Lyft accident, or slip and fall? Call Rubenstein Law. Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL and visit one of our offices throughout Florida.
It's the 4 o'clock hour on ESPN 106.3, fueled by Celsius, essential energy drinks.
As far back as I could remember, I always wanted to be a...
Josh Cohen and Home Team.
The Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
It is said that every day above ground is a good day and that some are just better than others. And I got people for decades that have come up to me in public and said, every day above ground's a good day. Every day is. And they're right. And I'm right. Today's one of those days that's a little better. It is the beginning of the madness that we know for the month that is. Today is day one of the NCAA tournament. And we are live just adjacent to the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook. This is a historic day in the state of Florida and for the home team, because for as many years as we've been live on and during the tournament, we've never done it where betting on the games is actually legal in the state of Florida. And today, for the first time ever, it is. The Seminole Hard Rock Hotel, Casino, and Resort, and the home of Hard Rock Bet, we are sitting here just outside the confines and directly across from actual tellers who are taking money, CCAT,
yeah,
as you said, and then handing people back more money from their cash tickets. People are actually winning so far today. Clearly, they were listening to Stone and I the other day. We gave our guide to avoid March sadness. So far, so good, Stoney. So far, so good.
So far, so good, brother love.
CCAT, by the way, happy madness, or shall I say, gladness of March to you. It's a holiday for me. I don't know if you feel the same way, but for me, this is a holiday.
You know, I had this prepared before the show. This is the day that is most like Christmas in the sports calendar.
Because feels that
it
way.
Starts early enough. It's not a full day of anticipation, the waiting for 6 o'clock for the Super Bowl, waiting for primetime. No, it's
12:15.
A full day of betting on sports, of watching the madness, watching it all.
It's more than just betting on the games. It's more than that. It's the fact that you begin the day with hope. You believe that your bracket might actually this year win it all. You believe that your teams might actually come through. And then generally by the time you're eating dinner, you realize it's probably not your year.
Yeah.
But with Hard Rock Bet, and if you've not signed up, do that. Remember, you get a no-regret first bet up to $100, meaning if your first bet doesn't win, if it's whatever it may be, up to $100 of it, you'll get back to take another chance on another bet after it proves that first bet wasn't a winner. So if you bet $50 and didn't win your first bet, well, your no-regret comeback is going to be a $50. If it was $100, it's $100. But the point I'm trying to make is brackets get broken, dreams get crushed, but at least with Hard Rock Bet on your phone, on your tablet, on your computer, whatever, as you go through the tournament, there's new hope, whether it's live wager in the middle of a game or a second-half line, or picking a team to advance to the Sweet 16 or to the National Championship or the Final Four. You know how it works. It is the gladness of the month of March, and we're in the midst of it. So we're glad to be live on location, and we're glad to be down here at the home, the physical home of the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook and Sports Bar, the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. The madness has begun. We got a couple early winners, as I'm sure you're aware, and that means a couple early losers as well. But really, the madness has begun, and it comes to us from Major League Baseball. And it is Topic A, Shohei Ohtani, and this enormous scandal involving his translator, no longer an employee of the Giants, a alleged Orange County, California, large-scale, illegal sportsbook operation. Major League Baseball has a problem on its hands. Shohei Ohtani has a problem on his hands. The Dodgers have a problem on their hands. And the translator, the former translator, he's got significant issues, as you might imagine, as well. The story gets very, very complicated where it didn't need to become complicated. It becomes complicated because during an investigation of bank wires that were sent to this alleged who's being investigated on a federal scale bookmaker in California, Shohei Ohtani name on wire slips, meaning that money was sent from Shohei Ohtani in the spelling of his legal name. There's no H after the O in the last name, legally. $500,000 wire payments. Multiple wire payments at $500,000. Not from an account that is somehow a business connected, related to, from literally a bank account in the name of Shohei Ohtani. Numerous $500,000 wire payments sent. That much we know for certain. Why they were sent and on whom's behalf, this is where it gets cloudy. So as the story has it, the former translator, right-hand man of Shohei Ohtani since 2016, he spoke openly about a gambling problem. And he admitted to investigators and to media that he got himself in trouble betting illegally on sports, but never baseball, international soccer, football, college football, other sports. And then he got himself into more trouble than he could handle, which required him to pay off an alleged $4.5 million gambling loss debt, and in doing so, having to notify his employer/partner, Shohei Ohtani, and ask for his help in paying off some of this debt. This is where it gets complicated, because on Tuesday, the translator is speaking of, I got in trouble, and I made these bets. I lost this money. I had to tell Shohei. He was disappointed in me, and he was willing to help me out. And so he wired money on my behalf. Okay, well, that's one explanation. Problem is, the next day, the story changed. Suddenly, it went from, well, no, that's not what happened, you see. See, what happened is, well, according to the spokesman, I know we said that yesterday, but that's not exactly how it worked out. See, what happened, well, what happened was, as Kevin Hart said, is the payments were never made by Shohei. He wasn't aware of this whatsoever. Instead, the interpreter, well, he stole this money. He sent those payments. He did this without any knowledge of Shohei Ohtani. Knowledge, none, let alone consent. This is grand theft on behalf of the former translator. But the problem is, the story changed. And I don't just mean by the dude who confessed. I mean by the spokesman on behalf thereof. And the problem is, the timeline doesn't match, because you've got this being public knowledge, him sharing on the record that Shohei made these payments from his account with me sitting there. I told him where to direct the money to help me out. $500,000 deposits, numerous. He's disappointed in me. I'm never going to bet on sports again. Went from that to then, in a very small time window, but long enough that that was public knowledge, the two of them coexisting in the dugout in Korea together, friendly and joking, etc. And if that were the case, well, then you would have had an instance in which, how could it be true if, in fact, you didn't know, but I just said that were the case, and you're aware that I said that was the case. So now the story shifts to, you stole from me. I'm pretty sure that if you made allegations and I made payments on your behalf for $500,000 at a clip several times illegally to an illegal bookmaker, we would be cohabitating pleasantly in the dugout together. And I'm also quite certain that if you stole from me, if you did it on your own, hacked into my banking, and somehow were able to wire $500,000 numerous times, since that was a statement that was later given, we also wouldn't be in the dugout cohabitating and coexisting and being friendly and smiling. Something is not right, clearly. It's the why that matters most, because Major League Baseball has a real problem on their hands. The Dodgers have a real problem on their hands. And this is a reminder. The irony is not lost on me that we are here with Hard Rock Bet, which, by the way, if this existed in California, none of this would have had to have happened. And this is exactly why you don't deal with illegal bookmakers. This is exactly why you don't mess with that stuff, because it can not only ruin careers, it can send people to prison. And in the instance of this story here, all of this could have been avoided if, in fact, they could have used a safe, legal sports book like we have in Florida now with Hard Rock Bet.
In the past 24 hours in this story, there was at least one lie told, right? The two stories, the two versions of the story are conflicting.
Correct.
And what makes me think is if someone was willing to lie, the truth has to be worse than those situations. And that's when it kind of opens up the possibilities where you could implicate Shohei Ohtani in worse conduct and worse actions than are in either one of the stories. So you're trying to protect this face of baseball across the world. It might not be the truth that Shohei Ohtani did some stuff he shouldn't have been doing, but now the possibility exists if there are lies being told or a lie being told that tries to protect him.
You're right. A lie was told. Both of those stories, one of them may be true, but we know that one of them can't be.
Yeah.
Okay? So what we like to do in criminology, criminal justice, and in my science, which again, beyond nonverbals, is deception and deceit detection, which is not an absolute science. I want to make that very clear. Deception and deceit detection is not an absolute science. People do not exhibit the same traits while being deceptive and or deceitful. Unlike body language, nonverbals, which is a science, because people without vision in China will exhibit the same nonverbals as people here in America who have seen their whole lives. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
You don't learn from observing others. Your body language is embedded in your DNA, your limbic brain. It's been there for thousands and thousands to hundreds of thousands of to millions of years going back in the ancestry of your family tree and in genetics of human beings. So deception and deceit. Not telling the whole truth and flat out lying. One of the two stories that we got is not true. We know that for sure. We do not know that the other one is in fact true, because there are other options on the table. What can be the case? Well, we know this for fact. Let's just separate, because what we like to do is process of elimination, weed out the things that are not. We know for fact that bank transmissions were made from the account of Shohei Ohtani to the illegal bookmaker. And they were done numerous times in the amount of $500,000. That is indisputable. That is undeniable. That's acknowledged by Shohei Ohtani's attorneys. Okay? So that's the key piece. Payments were made. Now it comes down to who and why. I'm not in the business of trying to get people in trouble. This whole story and all that comes with it the last 24 hours reeks of people wanting somebody to be in trouble, of wanting somebody to be in trouble for, ooh, what you did and ooh, what you... And a lot of it probably comes from, let's be honest, jealousy and envy of people who have a lot of money. The translator was paid by the Dodgers between $300,000 and $500,000 a year. Shohei Ohtani is on the cusp of, when this contract is done, $700 million in all. Highest contract in North American sports history, certainly blows any baseball contract out of the water. So who made the payments? Why were the payments made? And who was aware? We could guess and speculate. We're not in the business of that. I'm not interested in that. But it's a fun game for everyone to play. It's a whodunit. Was Shohei the one betting? Was the translator the one betting?
Yeah.
Who was the one who actually was responsible for those losses? Now, why does that matter, you say? Well, because it's a crime in the state of Florida. Excuse me, in the state of California. It is no longer a crime here if you do it through the only legal channel, Hard Rock Bet. That's not a plug. It's just a reminder of why you don't do that stuff. So, not just is it an issue, both of these individuals are subject to the CBA rules and laws of Major League Baseball, as well as the laws of the Los Angeles Dodgers. The interpreter's been fired. Ohtani today played. He was not available, made available to media to speak on this or answer any questions about this. But it's relevant because aside from the laws of the state of California and the United States of America, you've got laws that preside over Major League Baseball regardless of your club. So, if the wagers were made by Ohtani, that's a worst-case scenario problem for baseball.
Yeah.
If the wagers were made by the interpreter, but Ohtani did make the payments or was aware of the payments being made, that's still a problem for Major League Baseball. And a problem, mind you, still for Shohei Ohtani. It's just not on the same level if he's not the one participating in the gambling. It's still illegal for him to associate and know that he is participating in an illegal sportsbook making operation. It's just to a lesser degree. You get a little bit of leeway in that you're helping out, you're breaking the law, and you're breaking the laws of baseball. But also, thank God, you're not the one who's actually responsible for the sports betting. So it's lesser, but he's still not off the hook, if in fact that were the case.
Yeah, if you break the law and you're trying to get out of it, it's like, all right, what's our story? That's the cut. We talked about cutting your losses last week. That story,
yes.
The first story that broke, that he bailed his translator, his best buddy, out by paying off his gambling debts, that's kind of the story that cuts your losses, right? Because you're not completely you're not admitting that you made these wagers, because we don't know if he did or not. You're not saying you did that, but you're also not throwing your translator under the bus, completely absolving Shohei Ohtani because the money was taken out of his bank account without his knowledge.
But this isn't $5,000. This isn't this isn't $50,000. This is $500,000 on multiple occasions. It is extraordinarily difficult to bank wire. I don't care whose account it is and where it's going. In 2024, to bank wire $500,000 multiple times, it is incredibly difficult to do that without the consent and or help of the account holder. Incredibly. So was there an account that wasn't Shohei's, if you will? His name is on it, but it's not, he doesn't know. And we're not going to play, you know, the guessing game. What we're here to do is tell you what the story is, separate fact from conjecture, and just help you work through the process of elimination. There are multiple explanations for what this could be. Unfortunately, when asked to provide the explanation of what it was, they gave two different stories. That's always a bad sign. And in doing that, it tells us that one of them is not true, and there's a good chance the other one isn't either. But as we always say, in deception and deceit detection, and I include myself in that because it's something that I study, I can't think of a more useful skill in life than knowing what people are actually thinking and feeling, and oh, by the way, knowing when you're being lied to. So that's why I study what I study. There's a term we use, and you hear it all the time in law enforcement, and you hear it all the time with lawyers in trial. If you're telling the truth, there's nothing to remember.
Right.
If you're telling the truth, it just automatically flows. It's when you got to tell a lie that then you cause yourself to have to remember the details that you provided. This is why you'll have good cop, bad cop. And this is why a cop will interview someone and say, tell me the story, man, what happened? And then you tell all the details. And then they go, hold on a second. And then their partner comes in. The other, good cop, bad cop. So the bad cop just left. He's the hard ass. They already gave you up. You're making a fool of yourself right now. You're going to go to prison for a long time. They already told me everything. Why don't you tell on them like they told on you? They want your story. And then that cop goes, I got to bounce. But then the good cop comes in and goes, that guy's a jerk. Nobody likes him. Listen, man, he's full of nonsense. Just tell me what happened. They want to see if, A, you're going to talk differently to Good Cop, and they want to see if the stories mesh. They want to see if there's consistency. These idiots already botched this by having significant inconsistency while being on the record with the official spokesperson. It's one thing if the translator changes his mind, but it's another thing if the spokesperson was present and then came back later and said, well, no, see. But again, take a look at what was here yesterday morning. That's not the same time in Korea, obviously. And you know that either this dude just told everybody that you made $500,000 payments on his behalf to an illegal bookmaking operation and you're screwed and you're coexisting, cohabitating, and get along smiling, laughing in the dugout, or you know that this man stole millions of dollars from you and is now jeopardizing your entire livelihood in baseball, your brand, your career, your name, your perfect image, and you're coexisting, cohabitating, smiling, laughing in the dugout. When you put it that way, you realize there's bigger problems here.
Yet neither story would garner that nonverbal reaction between one another. Like, the Shohei Ohtani was not done completely wrong by this translator, if we're looking at it that way.
Shohei Ohtani would have known either of those situations. Both of those situations. If one of them were to be true, there's no way in hell he is coexisting and, for lack of a better term, playing nice with a man who could have and would have done that to him. So, there's always three sides to a story. Between a man, a woman, a man, a woman, a woman. There's always three sides. He said, she said, and then there's a sliding scale of somewhere in between comes the truth. Sometimes someone's 100% telling the truth. Sometimes there's 62%. This is a fascinating tale that could not happen at a worse time for baseball and for Shohei Ohtani. This is a problem. The good news, if there's any, is that it happened in California, a state in which sports betting is not yet legal, but clearly should be. There's going to be a deep dive. Beyond what the federal government is currently investigating, baseball will then have to. But remember, baseball's got skin in the game. Baseball doesn't necessarily want the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Baseball wants to protect itself. Worst case scenario, you find out that there are bets to this bookie from those accounts or that account that bet on games that Ohtani played in. Worst case is that bets were made by and from that account for the teams that Ohtani played on, i.e. the Angels, or the International Baseball, to lose those games.
Yeah.
Or under on runs, or under on total bases. This is where it gets slippery. And again, the irony is not lost on me that we are live from Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino, and just across, we are looking directly at the new Hard Rock Bet Sports Bar and the sports book itself, where there are live tellers that are taking tickets and giving tickets and paying people. Because if Hard Rock Bet were legal in California, like it is in Florida, none of this would have had to have happened. But this is why you can't deal with illegal sportsbook operations. Now, beyond that, I know plenty. And beyond that, I know plenty that don't hurt nobody, don't do no harm. The smart ones dealing cash. You got to be an idiot of a massive scale to not think that $500,000 multiple wire transmissions from a major bank to somebody who's been running book in Orange County, California, aren't going to be on the radar. That is next level stupidity.
So you think that
stupidity?
If we saw...
It's the equivalent of calling the cops to say that the weed you bought is half oregano and half skunk weed, and you paid good money for this weed, and they're going to say, sir, buying marijuana is illegal, and you're going to say, I didn't get what I was. Like, it's that level of stupid, but beyond that, because it's federal prison, you were saying.
So if there was a deep audit, and we kind of showed all the light on the cockroaches, they scrammed.
What deep audit?
a deep audit of all the transactions, and it wasn't that. It wasn't Ohtani directly wiring money to this bookmaker who's getting cooked right now. If it was...
Alleged bookmaker.
If it was...
Under investigation.
On Wednesday, Ohtani took out $500,000 in cash, and on Thursday, his translator deposited $500,000 in cash. In your brain, you think that would further implicate that Ohtani was doing something more wrongdoing?
No. I'm not getting into that stuff. I'm talking about a $500,000 wire from an individual to an individual is going to, that's going to be reported by the bank, you understand, to the authorities, regardless of whether they're investigating something or not. You get that, right?
Yeah, yes.
So, cash is king, baby. You know what $1 million weighs in $100 bills?
No.
Take a guess.
I'm going to guess it weighs...
I know this.
25 pounds.
It's a pretty good guess, bro.
Really?
It's pretty good. 22 pounds.
Oh, okay.
That's a pretty good guess. In $100 American bills, $1 million weighs about 22 pounds. So you can get, the hard part is getting the cash. But if you really need to help a friend out in need, you got to think a little bit in advance. I have a hard time believing that Shohei Ohtani is so stupid that he doesn't know that wiring $500,000 multiple times to an alleged bookmaker is something that won't raise red flags. I have a hard time believing that's the case. I don't know the man. I've never spoke to the man. But I have a hard time believing that he wouldn't think, boy, this might show up on somebody's radar. Hard time.
So what do those supporting details push you towards to think then? If you don't think Shohei could possibly be that stupid, so does that...
Oh, no. He could be.
Could be.
I said I have a hard time believing.
Okay.
I have a hard time.
So then what
it's very possible.
So what does that make you think?
So here's the real possibilities of what this could be. It could be version A. Interpreter got in a lot of trouble betting. Ohtani wanted to bail him out, help him out, was there to help send those wires. That's very plausible. That's option A. So you say to yourself, well, why wouldn't you stick to that story? Well, I can tell you why. Because it means that then Mr. Ohtani knows that you are illegally betting on sports. He's aware of this. He's associating with you. And Mr. Ohtani is now paying off those debts. He's funding organized crime in a massive illegal scale. Millions of dollars that the IRS is not aware of to an illegal business. Not only was he aware of it, you're saying now, but he also participated knowingly, willingly. So, oops, we can't do that. Well, we already said that. I know, but here's what we're going to do instead. Option B. The interpreter logged in, had the information, was able to fire off these wire transmissions on his own. He did it on his own. Mr. Ohtani had no knowledge whatsoever. Is it plausible? Sure, it's plausible. Here's the third option. Mr. Ohtani was full well aware of who he was dealing with and what he was doing sending the money. He was all along the one who was betting, and his interpreter was merely there to then be fall guy or to be the front in case there was any question and didn't want any suspicions to be raised. I can tell you about those with gambling problems. I can tell you that they do not have a problem lying or stealing or being desperate to get action, to have action. And if that means betraying people closest to them, that's something they're willing to do. A sickness no different than a prescription pain addiction, no different than severe alcoholism, a disease every bit the same.
So I'm trying to put this into Breaking Bad terms, right? The second statement that right now Shohei Ohtani is the victim in this situation, that his money has been stolen.
That he was unaware.
Exactly.
The money was stolen. Right.
That's Skylar White at the end, where they try to play it off as if she had no idea how in the world did this all happen. Skylar White had no idea when she did.
Do me a favor. Don't put it in Breaking Bad circumstance because not everyone's seen it.
Okay.
But also, you're getting into the down the road, end of the road. And I'm not saying that is an option. I'm saying the possibility exists that Ohtani was not aware that this had happened. Second statement's true. The possibility exists. Ohtani participated, tried to help out his translator. First option's true. Possibility also exists. This is all on Ohtani. And now the convenient fall guy is going to be the front, and that is the translator. And really those three options are what you have to work with. So we know that one of the first two is not true.
Yeah.
Because they conflict each other, and they are both offered up by the, in this case, investigated parties. So not the defendants or the defense, not yet anyway. So then you get down to it's one of the two of those, or it's the last option. And really that's what you got to work with.
It's all going to come out, and there's going to be a lot of...
Is it? Will it?
I think time will tell, and time will tell us the story.
Do
yes.
do you get the feeling like I do that there was this quest and thirst for someone to be in trouble? That they, because it, for the most part, is a very victimless crime. It is still against the law and still a crime, but there's a category we call victimless, right? Meaning you're doing it to yourself. Well... But the IRS, this is not being reported. And then the criminal aspects that come from and entities that run out of bookmaking, I get all that. Trust me, I grew up in it. I've known it my whole life. With that said, there seems to be this fascination with somebody getting in trouble because we love to see people get in trouble. When you're a little kid in school, you're in trouble. We love it. It never changes. All the crime shows, all the Nancy Grace stuff and cable news since the O.J. Simpson trial in 1995 has been, ooh, you're in trouble. Ooh, they get somebody in trouble. Someone's to blame. Blame game is America's favorite game. The NFL is second. Our favorite game is the blame game. Who's to blame? This is going to be a fun little mystery to play for a couple of months perhaps. But with that said, something I want to remind people. Number one, if you tell the truth, there's nothing to remember. Number two, as I say on this show all the time, the cover-up is always worse than the crime. Because the crime, you can defend. The cover-up is premeditated, preconceived, knowing you did something wrong, and attempting to avoid that altogether. The cover-up is always worse than the crime. And in this case, it may prove to be fatal.
That's where I'm getting at here, is that if there was only one statement made, either of the stories, okay, I would like to...
One's better than two.
Yes, one is...
And one's better than none.
Definitely better than two. But the fact that there were the two and one of them has to be a lie makes me immediately think, ooh, someone's in trouble and someone should get in trouble. Whether it is this ultimate betrayal, this guy is with Shohei every step down the road, and he has the gall to do something like that.
Question is, why would you change the first story? Yeah. Why would you change the first explanation? But why would you do that? And I can tell you why. If I'm the prosecutor in this instance, I'd say it's very simple. They have, while proving he's a loyal, good friend and associate, they have voluntarily implicated Mr. Otani as someone who knowingly and willfully sent money of $500,000 on numerous occasions to what he knew was an illegal bookmaking operation to cover illegal gambling debts in the state of California. Mr. Otani's participated in this, which is a confession of guilt. So your second story has to remove him, so he's got no part in that.
So his lawyers got involved. His lawyers said, whoa, we can't. That's not the story. No.
It blows my mind that wire payments of $500,000 were made from that man. That much we know for fact. It's the other options of who knew what, who was aware of the payments being made. That's the area that we can have a little bit of fun with, if you will. It blows my mind that someone of his level, status, stakes, place in global industry, Major League Baseball's global face, is in the middle of this. It blows my mind. It goes to show you sometimes that people really are not as sharp as you think and assume they would be. Coming up when we return, we got some sound from the principals in this. We got the actual reporter, Tisha Thompson, who broke this story. She's the one who spoke at length to the interpreter. We'll hear from her as well. Plus, the NCAA tournament is underway. Did we talk about that? Did we point that out at all?
I think we made note of it early.
I'm watching right now the halftime show. One of them, at least, one of these games at halftime. We'll get an update on all the tournament games, plus the NCAA tournament coach that is a, quote, dead man walking. You know, the head coach out there at Long Beach State. He said what at media availability about still being on the job? as we check the clock, he may not be on the job any longer, as a matter of fact. But we'll find out what that is coming up next. F1 Miami, the 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix. May 3rd through the 5th, three-day event filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and, of course, the greatest racing in the world for three straight days. It is the season's first sprint race in the Americas. Come watch the greats like Max Verstappen, Lewis Hamilton, as they battle it out. There is a variety, by the way, of ticketing options. Campus passes, grandstand, seats, luxury hospitality, each with track views that are unbelievable, putting you right in the center of the action. This event gets bigger and it gets better every single year. General admission passes available now, low as $150. Join us for the 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix, May 3rd through the 5th. A one-of-a-kind event showcasing the incredible sport of F1 and reflecting Miami's unique position as the global curator of culture. Tickets available now at F1 Miami GP. That's F, the numeral 1, Miami GP.com. We are back live in the midst of March Betness with Hard Rock Bet. Safe, fun, legal, most importantly in Florida. The irony's not lost on me. I'll repeat that. That whole Ohtani story never had to happen if, in fact, Hard Rock Bet were legal in California and they had the opportunity to do that. It's a reminder, kids. Maybe this may be a sign from above. It's time to go legit.
Uh-huh.
And sign up quick and easy for Hard Rock Bet. Home team live from the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook at Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. This is ESPN 106.3.
This summer in Paris, the world's best go for the gold. This summer in South Florida, get the gold. Plan, that is, from EDS Air Conditioning. Ken Levicka here, and as always, EDS is yes. EDS Air Conditioning, keeping your home cool. As a trained comfort specialist, it's hard to stop a train. With the EDS Gold Plan, you get numerous benefits, including two yearly tune-ups to keep your AC unit world-class. EDS is yes. EDSAirConditioning.com. Make your family and your nation proud with the Gold Plan from EDS Air Conditioning. EDS is yes. EDSAirConditioning.com.
Time now for a PNC pause. PNC Bank is committed to making a difference in the lives of the customers they serve in the South Florida community. See how at PNC.com. You are listening to ESPN 106.3.
All right, sports fans, let's get ready for some world-class soccer action. The MLS Showdown is happening, and it's happening right in your backyard at Chase Stadium in Fort Lauderdale. Come see him for yourself, the greatest of all time, the legendary goal scorer. Watch him create real magic, and after the game, indulge in a winning lineup of eats, drinks, and adventures in greater Fort Lauderdale. It's the perfect match. So make a fast break to visitlauderdale.com and check out some travel tips to score some goal-worthy fun in the vibrant heart of greater Fort Lauderdale.
You're listening to ESPN 106.3, presented by Rubenstein Law. 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Car accident, truck accident, Uber or Lyft accident, or slip and fall? Call Rubenstein Law. Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL and visit one of our offices throughout Florida.
Whether it's a clutch touchdown pass, a game-winning dunk, or a dash to the finish, we want to highlight the best performance of the week presented by Baptist Health South Florida. Every week, different teams will be highlighted across ESPN 106.3 and ESPN West Palm Play. The winning performance receives $500 courtesy of Baptist Health South Florida. Know of a team, player, or school with a killer performance? Nominate them today by emailing highschool@ESPNWestPalm.com. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care. Go where the pros go.
Hi, I'm Michael Manzo, owner and founder of Manzo's Italian Deli, and I...
Stop, Dad. After 20 years, people are tired of hearing your voice.
Yeah, and your lame-ass commercials.
Fresh prosciutto, mozzarella, outstanding.
Oh, please.
There's only one reason Manzo's has voted number one deli in Palm Beach County for 20 years. Our mother.
She makes sure you prepare everything from scratch using only the freshest ingredients.
Manzo's Italian Deli is located on Palm Beach Lakes Boulevard, right next to Rain Dancers.
Is that a strip club?
No, it's a steakhouse. Manzo's is open weekdays from 8 to 5 and offers free delivery. So stop by or call 697-9411. That's 697-9411.
We also specialize in hot and cold catering for corporate functions and special events.
Just ask anyone who was at my last birthday party.
Hey, it's Tina from Josh Cohen and the Home Team, and I wanted to remind you that Jay McLaughlin at the Gardens Mall carries clothing and accessories for women and men. The men's styles can take guys everywhere, from work to weekend to adventure, with clothes featuring standout colors and signature prints. These clothes are perfect to go from the office to the golf course to dinner without a wardrobe change needed. Visit Jay McLaughlin at the Gardens Mall on the upper level near Saks Fifth Avenue.
Time now for the Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week. Supporting local student-athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. Every Player of the Week is eligible to win a scholarship at the end of the year. This year, a $25,000 scholarship will be awarded to an athlete, with $10,000 going to the winner's high school athletic department. Land Rover Palm Beach, above and beyond. Here's Cade Chumsley.
Our Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week is Palm Beach Gardens wrestler George Bravo. George took third place at the state championships earlier this month, and this week he got to share with me some of his favorite memories from wrestling with the Gators.
There's so many memories that I've created, even with losses and wins, and I just like the overall experience that I've had with wrestling and going to tournaments in the offseason, going up to Tampa, Orlando, meeting a bunch of friends. I just like that, you know, that connection that I've made with people through wrestling.
Congratulations, George, on being selected the Land Rover Palm Beach Player of the Week. We look forward to seeing you down the road.
Are you tired like I am, falling asleep on the couch, groggy at work, losing focus on simple tasks? Ken Levicka here. Elite Anti-Aging Center can help. Low testosterone, hormonal imbalance. It's not just about your performance at the gym. It's the everyday grind life situations, and Elite Anti-Aging can help. Visit EliteTRT.com. Glenn and his team will give you that first virtual visit free. Don't wait until your next birthday. Do it now. Visit EliteTRT.com so you feel better about yourself.
It's the 4 o'clock hour on ESPN 106.3, fueled by Celsius, essential energy drinks. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
Couple of updated scores from the tournament. Of course, in action, Illinois leading Morehead State 39-38 at halftime. The three seed is an 11-point favorite. We'll see if they can't get moving a little bit here in the second half. Also, closing in on halftime, 4:15 remaining first half. Oregon leads South Carolina 23-22. Oregon, one of those slippery 11 seeds. Watch out. I've got two 11 seeds, in fact, I think, making Sweet 16. Somebody just wants some money.
Oh, yeah.
Here at Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. Earlier today, it's a final. Michigan State, Tom Izzo advances 69-51 over Mississippi State. Duquesne, or as Theo Dorsey refers to them, Duquesne, what did he say?
Duquesne.
Duquesne. Yeah, Duquesne, 71-67. A outright winner for the 9-point dog over BYU. Creighton advances over Akron as expected. They're laying 12. They won by 17. Arizona, who Hard Rock Bet had at minus what, 21.5? 20.5?
20.5.
So Hard Rock Bet had Arizona minus 20.5. In our March Betness picks, I took Long Beach State plus a 20.5. Arizona wins 85-65.
Yeah, we were on
that
the
half
air.
A point makes a difference.
We were either walking to our table, so we didn't see the end. There had to be a free throw right at the end that was going to push it one way or the other, and we ended up on the right side.
Yeah, you never know. You never know. Anyway, it is March Betness, paid in full by Hard Rock Bet. A reminder, Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys, car accidents, truck accidents, slip and fall, trip and fall. Anajar and Levine, accident attorneys, call 1-800-747-FREE, 800-747-3733. You get injured on the job? Call in a John Levine, accident attorneys. Listen, they will fight for you. They will fight to get you the maximum compensation. They do not get paid unless you get paid. You'll always talk about your case with an actual attorney. They answer the phone 24 hours a day, and they're going to help you take back control of your life. It's pretty simple. They were my accident attorneys. They can be your accident attorneys as well. 800-747-3733. That's 800-747-FREE. And it's John Levine, accident attorneys. Take back control of your life. Before we get into the fun stuff of the sadness of March, back to the Shohei Ohtani story, which is number one, maybe not just in sport, but also in news. Craig Carton, who knows a little something about illegal gambling and gambling problems, is a self-professed recovering gambling addict. He had strong words to say. In fact, this content was then made into a tweet that Fox put out, and then for some reason it was taken back. It was deleted.
Oh.
And let's not forget, Fox is, in fact, partners with Major League Baseball, as you are aware.
Yeah, yes.
To air the World Series, the American League Championship Series, etc. Take a listen to Craig Carton earlier today.
And the CBA is very, very clear in Major League Baseball. You cannot associate with known bookies, and you cannot gamble illegally. We'll get into that later on as well. And there are two wires from Shohei Ohtani's personal bank account. This has been verified by reporters who've seen it, into the hands of a bookie. By default, Shohei Ohtani must be suspended by Major League Baseball. And I'm not naive enough to tell you he will be. But the way the letter of the law works, the most prominent athlete in baseball on day two of the Major League Baseball season is now facing a legitimate and indefinite suspension for being associated with illegal gambling here in the United States.
So this is Craig Carton speaking on the CBA. Major League Baseball players cannot behave and conduct themselves in transactions such as this. If the first version were the truth, well, then they've implicated Ohtani is breaking the CBA, is now being subject to exactly what Carton says, and that is that suspension, and then some. That's why you don't want that to be true, and that's why you come back and say that's not at all what happened. Mr. Ohtani was the victim of large-scale theft. This money was stolen from him by his trusted translator and close friend who wired the money from Ohtani's account without his knowledge nor his consent. You see why that now applies?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And you know what? We make fun of Carton a lot on the show. Not a lot, but a couple times. When he's come up on the show, it's kind of at a expense.
Sounds drunk right there.
But it does almost every day, just how his voice goes. He has actual knowledge of how this works, illegal gambling. So yeah. I trust his word. Because sometimes when...
He went to jail too, don't forget.
Yeah, when sports gambling became widespread legal to more and more states, you'll have sports media personalities kind of fake it until they make it and try to learn that kind of thing, and they'll say this detail or that detail that knows that they're not a real gambler.
I don't watch Carton. Why? What did he say that impressed you on this?
That he's not talking at a class when he said this is textbook against the CBA.
Right. Yeah. No. I mean, if you read the rules, and you know who wants to, but if you read the rules, associating with, having knowledge of, here's what it is. The original story they gave is very unfortunate for Mr. Ohtani. Very unfortunate. You don't want that to be the truth. You don't want that to be your statement. You don't want to claim that that is what happened because you've now implicated yourself. You've implicated yourself. You've outed yourself as he knew where the money was going, and he sent it on multiple occasions. Because then you say, no more questions, end of story. You've now defied that. You've now broken these rules. That's not as bad in the hierarchy of MLB. It's like when a doctor says, I got bad news and I got worse news. You know?
Yeah.
So it's bad news for Ohtani. But the worst news is Ohtani was making these bets. Ohtani was betting out of control. Ohtani sent the money himself. Translator was the front. He was covering being the face of to protect Ohtani. That's worst case scenario. And we're not alleging that either of these is true. We're letting you know examples of what could be. Meanwhile, ESPN is airing the Dodger game this morning here in America. And during the game, the camera is on Shohei Ohtani in the dugout. And Carl Ravitch has an obligation to explain what's going on. Listen how ESPN handled this while broadcasting an MLB game with that team and that player involved. Listen.
Welcome back, everyone. The big story around the Dodgers overnight, Ipe Mitsuhara, that was the interpreter for Shohei Ohtani and a close friend, was fired. Questions surrounding at least $4.5 million, at least $4.5 million, in a wire transfer that was sent from Ohtani's bank account to a bookmaking operation set off a series of events. Mitsuhara incurred gambling debts to a Southern California bookmaking operation that is currently under federal investigation, multiple sources tell ESPN. On Tuesday, an Ohtani spokesman told ESPN the player transferred the funds to cover Mitsuhara's debt. On Wednesday, the same Ohtani spokesman said, "We discovered that Shohei has been the victim of a massive theft. We are turning the matter over to the authorities." Mitsuhara told ESPN in multiple interviews Ohtani had zero involvement in betting.
My question is, you've got an individual who admitted a gambling problem, who had a dream job, who just got fired, who's now in a lot of trouble. He says, he helped me, he wired this money, and then he comes back later and says, nope, he had nothing to do with it. So I guess what he's doing is saying, I lied the first time, and I have to admit that I stole from my friend.
He being the translator.
Right.
Lied the first time.
So I guess what we've got now is a translator who's falling on the proverbial sword.
Yeah.
Or saying, yeah, I stole it. I stole from him. And it's all me. It's me. It's all me.
And they kind of watch a lot of movies where in these scenarios that could happen, if that's all true, if he lied, falling on the sword, he'll be taken care of after he's out of prison, after he's paying his debts.
Made whole.
Yeah. He'll be made whole after the fact. Someone in Shohei Ohtani's circle will make sure that this translator, this interpreter, is not completely thrown under the bus. He's got to take this bullet, though.
So, again, this we hope somebody gets in trouble. You know, this mentality, this mindset that people have of, ooh, hope somebody get. It comes from jealousy and envy of people's status, fame, wealth, and power. And really, people need to mind their own business. With that said, you know, it's crime. And shouldn't be afforded special and preferential treatment because of your fame, your power, your celebrity. You know, that's why the lady justice who weighs the scales of justice is wearing a blindfold. So she can't tell how rich you are and how young you are and how powerful and famous you are.
And also, Ohtani is now a Dodger, who is the second least favorite team in terms of favorability among other Major League Baseball fans. So the Yankees, okay. Dodgers are public enemy number one,
right.
And they got Ohtani for $1 million a year, deferring the big chunk of his contract until
right.
after. So they're not really paying for him, big competitive advantage. They're hoping for the downfall of the Dodgers, if you would.
Oh, for sure. For sure.
They being the public.
But the public still, when this story breaks, we're looking to see who can we get in trouble. If you haven't sensed that yet, tune into what I'm saying and you will. When we come back, which sports media personality just bet how much money, legally, on who to win the madness that is the month thereof? Which sports media personality bet how much on whom to win it all? And by the way, just so you know, it's not too late for you to get in on that same action, literally, figuratively, and literally, via Hard Rock Bet, to bet this team to win it all. You can still do that yourself. We'll get that coming up next. First, though, St. Lucie Battery and Tire, the home of honest, reliable service since 1970. You need batteries for vehicles. Beyond cars, yeah, they got car and truck batteries. Of course they do. But you need a battery maybe for a golf car, a side-by-side. They got those for everything. Tires for everything. Oil changes, faster and cheaper than the dealership where you bought your vehicle because of the cost of hourly labor. They can do all major and minor service and repair and maintenance, and they can do it also as a family-owned business with integrity and accountability. They're a great family. They're a great company. I first took my car to get an oil change from St. Lucie Battery and Tire. I think it was an oil change. 1998. Might have got a battery, as a matter of fact. Now that I think about it as well. That's 26 years ago, kids. SLBT.com, 17 locations, West Palm through the Treasure Coast. Again, 17 locations, West Palm to the Treasure Coast. SLBT.com, St. Lucie Battery and Tire. Great people. And also the home of honest, reliable service in 1970. We're back live in moments from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino.
the site of the actual Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook, beyond your phone, here in living, I guess, four dimensions of reality. It's the Home Team on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3.
Calling all sports fans, grab your MVP card and head to Duffy's where you can catch all of the action. Not an MVP? Sign up for free and start earning rewards today. Duffy's is voted the best sports grill year after year with their award-winning burgers and wings. Don't forget about Duffy's famous two-for-one drinks all day, every day. And with over 80 TVs in every location, you'll never miss a minute of the game. Visit Duffy'sMVP.com to learn more. Duffy's, our game is always on.
Habitat for Humanity of Greater Palm Beach County invites you to rediscover the Restores. Donate your new and gently used items or shop for great deals up to 60% off every day. Sales of donated items help Habitat for Humanity partner with local families to build and repair safe and affordable homes in our community. They are now offering easy online scheduling and faster pickup times. Schedule today with any of their five locations or visit habitatgreaterpbc.org to learn more. That's habitatgreaterpbc.org.
It's lights out in Miami. The 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix takes off May 3rd through the 5th. The three-day event is filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and, of course, top-notch racing. Tickets are available now. Choose from a variety of grandstands, each with a fantastic track view that puts you right in the center of the action and gives you access to the full campus. Visit F1MiamiGP.com. That's F1MiamiGP.com today.
PNC Bank is committed to helping the customers and the communities they serve move forward financially. To do this, they're implementing their community benefits plan that focuses on affordable home lending, small business loans, and employee volunteerism, and creating other opportunities to give back on a local level. They're proud to be a part of the South Florida community. See how PNC Bank can make a difference for you at pnc.com/ourcommitments. PNC Bank, National Association, member FDIC.
It's the 4 o'clock hour on ESPN 106.3, fueled by Celsius, essential energy drinks. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sportsbook. This is ESPN 106.3.
Consecutive days, a road game for the home team on the ride home. Today, we are inside the friendly confines, the gorgeous Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino Resort and Sportsbook. Hard Rock Bet. We are just outside where people are actively watching, wagering, live betting the tournament as we speak.
So many smiles.
People are winning today. That's why, because they're winning. Because they're getting in on live betting. And you can, too. Download the app from the App Store. Twin Peaks. We're not far from Twin Peaks, by the way. Just down the road. Pembroke Pines. Davie, right down the road from us. Cypress Creek. Hollywood. And, of course, West Palm Beach. Off of I-95 on Palm Beach Lakes Boulevard. Be a great day. Great night. Great weekend. To go to Twin Peaks. To watch all of the action. To catch the fights on Saturday as well. Remember, your UFC fight headquarters officially is Twin Peaks. You'll never ever pay a cover, never pay anything to watch any of the fights, boxing, MMA, and of course UFC, all for free. Plus, you got happy hour 5 days a week. You got menu favorites and brand new menu items continually being added. Cocktail concoctions as well on those happy hours and otherwise. And 29 degree beer plus Twin Peaks hospitality. Eats, drinks, scenic views, 29-degree beer, made from scratch favorites, the UFC fight headquarters, Twin Peaks. Which sports media personality just bet how much on whom to win the NCAA tournament? Let's drop that music for the Hard Rock betness. Shall we, Stone LeBanowitz? Thank you very much. Who am I talking about and who do you bet on? C-Cat, who am I talking about?
Are you talking about Dave Portnoy?
I'm talking about the president of Barstool Sports, Dave Portnoy.
Saw that he got 600 G's. Is that correct?
He bet $600,000 at odds of plus 360, meaning for every 100 he bets, if it wins, it pays 360 back. For every 1,000 that he bets, it pays 3,600. $600,000 wagered UConn to win the NCAA tournament, which means that his payout would be $2.76 million.
Man.
$2,760,000 is what it would pay out if, in fact, that $600,000 play cashes. Again, it's UConn to win the entire tournament.
And if you put $100 on UConn to win their first round game, you would win 50 cents or $1, depending on your book. But here at Hard Rock Bet, you would get 50 cents because they are minus.
When you say depending on your book, I mean, I don't know what you're talking about. There's one option in the state of Florida.
That's a good point.
Are you Shohei Ohtani all of a sudden? You translator idiot?
No, I'm not translator idiot. Not today, not ever.
How do you know I didn't mean translator comma idiot? How do you know what I mean it that way?
Yes, UConn is minus 220,000. 50 cents going today.
That's not a good return.
No.
just maybe bet them to win it all on Hard Rock Bet. Florida's only safe, legal. The only legal sportsbook, period. Coming up, when we return, we get in the cocktail hour. We go live to New York City. We've got insider to the NCAA tournament. We'll be calling the game, as a matter of fact, tomorrow. Celebrity surprise broadcaster calling NCAA tournament game. We're not going to tell you who. We're going to surprise you with who that is. Joining us live from just outside the Barclay Center. That comes up when we return next. Plus, part of March Betness is the Hard Rock Better Bracket. You know the Elite Eight?
Yeah.
Well, we got the Elite Eight ATE. Food related. You see what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Today's round one Elite Eight bracket, pizza styles.
Ooh.
There's always debate about the greater style of pizza. We'll get to that coming up next. Plus, we're going to make you some free money. It is the home team, live from some of the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino and the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook. Download the app now. Bet the games in 5 minutes. Home team on ESPN 106.3.
NHR and Levine accident attorneys call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose two of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious small fries for only $3.89. Now my day is made the tastiest way when I bundle and save at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid when product served.
When you're drinking a frozen beverage from McDonald's, your brain may not like how refreshingly cold it is, but the rest of your body, oh yes, it's gonna relish every moment of it, because there are drinks, then there are drinks from McDonald's.
Try any size frozen drink, like a frozen Fanta Blue Raspberry or a tasty frozen Coke for $1.49. At participating McDonald's, Coca-Cola and Fanta are registered trademarks of the Coca-Cola Company.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
What's the Anajar and Levine difference? When you're injured in a car crash, we focus on your case so you can focus on the one thing that matters most, getting better. I'm Glenn Levine with Anajar and Levine. We'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve. Call our legal team right now for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. We'll help you take back control of your life. Call 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office West Palm Beach.
The MVPs of sports and science are teaming up. Join Marlins legend Jeff Conine and Dolphins great Nat Moore, along with the top doctors from Sylvester Comprehensive Cancer Center, for breakfast on March 27th in Boca Raton. The Men for PAP conference will tackle the subject of men's health and cancer prevention in a fun and informative way, with a conversation led by ESPN West Palm's own Theo Dorsey. Get your tickets today at thepapcorps.org. That's PAPCORPS.org.
We are connected internationally. We have relationships in the diamond industry that go back decades. Sources all over the world.
International Diamond Center's owner Keith LeClaire explains how IDC always offers to beat anyone else's price on a diamond.
We buy direct from the cutters, we pay cash, and we just don't believe in typical jewelry store markups.
With his background as a wholesaler, Keith says IDC's business model is based on lower margins and higher volume.
We're not here to sell you something for a quick buck.
So it comes down to better sourcing and and low markups.
That's why we guarantee the best value price.
If you're buying a diamond, engagement ring, or any fashion jewelry, come experience a refreshing alternative to the typical jewelry experience at IDC.
We're here to offer the right price on every piece of jewelry that you buy from IDC.
Real value from real people.
We'd rather make a little bit and keep you as a customer than make a lot of it and lose you as a customer.
International Diamond Center, US 1 and PSL Boulevard, and online at shopidc.com.
Improve your golf game fast at the all-new Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center. The Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center has the facilities, tools, and coaching you need. Enjoy the best facilities in the area with an expansive chipping and putting area, practice bunkers, a huge putting green, plus a 2,000-square-foot indoor training area with three hitting bays, cutting-edge analysis technology, and more. The Kaiser University Golf Coaching Center in the heart of Palm Beach County off I-95 and the Turnpike. Find out more at kaisergolfcenter.com.
Looking for a venue that's as unique as your event? Look no further than Manatee Lagoon, an FDL Eco Discovery Center. Whether you're planning a wedding, business event, or a special celebration, our versatile venue spaces provide the ideal backdrop for any occasion. Enjoy panoramic waterfront views with rental options indoors or outside. Experience the beauty of nature while celebrating life's special moments. Book your event at Manatee Lagoon today at visitmanateelagoon.com/events. That's visitmanateelagoon.com/events.
Palm Beach County needs your participation to remain a top recycler in the state of Florida. Cardboard rolls like ones in the paper towels, toilet paper, and gift wrapping are items we accept in our recycling program. They go into the yellow bin. These and other recyclables are picked up at the curb and dropped off at the recycling facility. Keep our community clean and green by recycling right every day, Palm Beach County. Learn more at swa.org/recycleright.
Attention business owners, the next several months are going to be super busy. Why not let us take some of the burden off of you? Get the help you need from Intelligent Office in Palm Beach Gardens. Professional live receptionist to answer screen and forward all of your calls to you live. Why do you need a virtual assistant? No high salaries, no holidays or sick pay, no callouts, no turnover, and no additional equipment. Call 561-472-8400 or visit intelligentoffice.com to learn more how we can help you streamline your day.
When it comes to choosing a health plan, you can trust the members who have experienced it firsthand. Humana is proud to offer a Medicare Advantage plan in Florida that earned 5 out of 5 stars. 5 stars is the highest rating possible. It's based on real members' experiences, and it's decided by the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. Our Humana Gold Plus HMO earned 5 out of 5 stars. That means a few things. It means members get outstanding customer service. It means we connect them with excellent preventive care and chronic condition support. Most of all, it means you have a trustworthy option for a Medicare Advantage plan. Explore our 5-star Humana Gold Plus HMO at humana5star.com. Humana, a more human way to healthcare. Every year, Medicare evaluates plans based on a 5-star rating system. Humana is a Medicare Advantage HMO organization with a Medicare contract. Enrollment in any Humana plan depends on contract renewal.
ESPN 106.3. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sports book. This is ESPN 106.3.
As we are broadcasting live from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino and the Hard Rock Bet physical sports bar / sports book inside the casino resort. It is the first time in history that we have in a tournament and in the state of Florida, we can bet it and play it and live wager it and parlay it legally and do it from our phones and our tablets and our computers or in person, the kiosk, or in person with a damn teller. I got a tear in my eye. It's a special day for someone that's been in this state for a very long time, for this day to have finally come. We'll get into the cocktail hour in just a second. We got a special guest joining us in just a second who'll be actually calling the NCAA tournament tomorrow from the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. And we'll get him on in just a second. You know what? Let's bring Frank Sinatra on first and foremost, because it is the cocktail hour.
It's the cocktail hour.
For me, it is right now.
And the Cocktail Hour is being brought to you by F1 Miami. Tickets available now for the F1 Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix, May 3rd through the 5th. The three-day event with art, music, world-class cuisine, and the greatest racing in the world is also the season's first sprint race in the Americas. And I'm talking about Max Verstappen and Lewis Hamilton and all the greatest drivers in the world. And I'm talking about the celebrities and the sights to be seen, the see and be seen scene, that is. And when I say see and be seen scene, you understand that the second scene is S-C-E-N-E.
Yeah.
Where the first scene is S-E-E-N.
Correct.
I'm just making sure.
Yeah.
Just making sure.
Very clever.
The least I can do. Pay me for something. Choose from a variety of ticketing options. Grandstand throughout. Fantastic track views. Putting you in the center of the action. You can feel it. You can actually feel the race cars.
Pumping in your chest.
Well, I mean, you feel the vibration. You feel the power. You physically can feel the reverberations. General admission passes available from as low as $150. Do me a favor. Secure your passes now. Go to the letter F, the numeral 1. When I say numeral, it means just the number 1. You don't spell it out. F1MiamiGP.com. And join us for the 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix, May 3rd through the 5th, which, by the way, showcases the one-of-a-kind event that is and the incredible sport of F1 and reflecting Miami's unique position as the global curator of entertainment, sport, and culture. And with that, we send it now live to Brooklyn, New York, the site of the NCAA tournament tomorrow, and our very own host of LaVica, Theo, and Stone, the voice of the FAU Owls, the longest surviving former member of the home team experiment, Ken LaVica. Kenny, thanks for taking time. You're appreciated.
I am really jealous. I didn't know you guys were actually physically at the sports book. Hey, that's sick.
We are. In fact, a woman sitting across from us playing some kind of a progressive card table game, we have reason to believe she just won $180,000.
Mm-hmm. Are you serious?
And it's a like a $20 table. It's like a $20 very working class table. People started screaming and celebrating, and then Jacob, the intern, looked over and believes that she won $180,000.
That's insane. That's awesome.
Kenny, congratulations on your tournament appearance, second consecutive year. We're excited for FAU. They got a tough draw, obviously, round one. Some believe that the seeded did not do them any favors. We're not going to look ahead. So take us a little bit inside what we're dealing with tomorrow, Northwestern, in a game that tips off just after noon.
Yeah, Northwestern is a team that finished fourth in the Big Ten. They've beaten Purdue. They've beaten Illinois. They've got signature wins in conference. Much like FAU, some head-scratching non-conference losses like Chicago State at home. But this is a Northwestern team that is really good. Boo Booey is one of the top scorers in the nation. He's the leading scorer in Northwestern history, 2,000 points plus in his career. FAU's not going to be able to stop him. They're just going to need to try and neutralize him. Outside of him, Northwestern's just a really good shooting team, and they've got size that can shoot as well. FAU's going to be the faster team. They're going to be the more athletic team, but you better get hands in face. You better defensively get up in chests, which FAU has struggled at times this year to do, because you're going to need to keep Northwestern within arm's length. But you've got maybe the game with the two best offenses going at one another tomorrow in Brooklyn.
Ken LaVica, our own host of LaVica, Theo, Stone, weekdays noon to 2, ESPN 106.3, worldwide on all smart speakers. Just tell it, play ESPN West Palm. And, of course, the ESPN app. And, of course, on our YouTube channel, ESPN West Palm Play, joining us. He's also the voice of the FAU Owls. He was the unlikely hero of the ending of the Elite Eight game in which he found a way to keep a cable connected. That story made viral by Brian Anderson, who'll be on the television side. Kenny, go ahead.
Well, get this real quick just off of that. So Ian Eagle, Bill Raftery, and Grant Hill are doing the FAU game on CBS television tomorrow. Nice. And so I had never met Ian Eagle. I have known of him through others, and so I went up and introduced myself, and he said, "Oh, Ken," he's like, "your equipment's going to work this year, right?" So even at the heights of the broadcast mountain that Ian Eagle encompasses, I'm known as the Ethernet guy.
No, I was going to say, your nickname should be Jim Carrey, the cable guy. Cable guy. Everyone should greet you. Cable guy. That would be my dream come true. If Ken is known throughout the NCAA tournament as the cable guy.
The other nickname I've heard for Ken was Hollywood yesterday. Hollywood Ken LaVica, after he was greeted with rounds of applause while he was getting on the team bus, was it, or the team plane?
Who said there was any rounds of applause?
On the team bus to go to the airport. Yeah,
Ken, were there rounds of applause for you?
Yes, people know me, man. I've been at FAU for 18 years, man. I am a strong entity. I am a personality. I'm beloved in the FAU
community.
We don't
deny that. We don't deny that.
Rousing applause.
We don't deny that, but were there rounds of applause? Was there really? Because the pictures that I saw, most of the students looked to be laughing.
That is not true. They were, that was in awe. You misinterpreted.
They were in awe. They were awestruck.
They're awestruck. Rounds of rousing applause is what took place as I walked to the bus yesterday.
By the way, Stone LeBanowitz, who's producing this show right now, he took your photo that you posted, he quoted it, and then he said, "Dude looks like he's suiting up to play." And then you told him that, you know, Stone, you don't know what it's like for people to be happy to see you. I thought that was very hurtful. I also thought, Ken, that you were confusing him with me, because no one's ever happy to see me. People are actually happy sometimes to see Stone.
Yeah, I lashed out. And I look back, and I shouldn't have been so harsh. It was very mean and very rude. I was mad at Stone because the one time that I post a picture that someone else took of me doing my career things,
cool.
And I don't try and put that stuff out there often, but I did, and then I've got Stone. He's criticizing me. I thought it was unfair, but I also apologized today because it was very inappropriate of me to just lash out at Stone like that.
I understand completely. Well, I thought the most amusing and amazing part was the student reactions, and I want to point out that you are drawing reactions because they are looking at you. They are noticing you. They are watching you. So whether or not they're in awe, or whether or not they're like this guy, or whether or not the one dude looks like a tough guy, so go, yeah, he just wants you to acknowledge him. If you made eye contact with the one kid, you know, with the white T-shirt with his head back, if you just pointed his way or shot your little air guns, pew, pew, you would have made his whole year. He would have done
Man,
for
do
you.
Finger guns.
You would have done for him what Ian Eagle did for you by saying, "Ken, is your equipment going to work this year?" Been the same thing.
Was it Joe Green throwing the jersey?
Yes.
The hat off and throw it to the kid.
It would have been the same thing, Ken.
Yeah. No, well, I'm living this too. So my wife and my daughters came up here to New York as well. And
awesome.
My daughters love Vlad Goldin. He's FAU 7-1 center. And they call him the Giant. And I had to tell them, I warned him. I'm like, "Hey, they call you the Giant. Don't be offended." He's like, "Oh, that's good. That's good." He's fine with it. The big Russian center for FAU. But I had to tell them, like, he's got a name. Call him Vlad. But they're obsessed with him. Every time they see him, they run up to him, hug his knees. They want to eat next to him, the whole thing. So he makes their day constantly.
You know what it is? They think that he's a theme park character. They don't realize he's a college boy. They think that he's like a character walking around Disney World.
He literally, to them, is larger than life, and I get a kick out of that because they cannot get enough of him.
Speaking of larger than life, Ken LaVica, photograph surfacing today of you being carried by Chris Canty like a teddy bear. Was that to scale? Was that really you and your full body compared to Chris Canty?
Yeah, that was. Yeah, I stopped by the ESPN Seaport studios and hung out with the unsportsmanlike crew, and they're on every day 6 to 10 a.m. on ESPN 106.3. But Evan was there, and Chris Canty, Michelle Smallman. And so Evan was like, "Ken, stand next to Chris Canty. Stand next to Chris Canty." And the thing is, I just mentioned Vlad Goldin, and he's well put together at 7'1", but Chris Canty is 6'7", and also built like a dump truck.
Yeah.
There are not many human bodies like that, and I look like a doll standing next to that guy.
Yeah, he is ginormous. All right, Ken, so you're on the road, FAU tomorrow, tipping off with Northwestern just after noon. The number one broadcast team, by the way. You said you got Rafferty and Ian Eagle and Grant Hill. They'll call the national championship and Final Four game, so FAU's getting that superstar treatment. Last year,
you guys showed up in the tournament. There wasn't a whole lot of expectation, and people were just treating the program outside of this area as being one of those also-ran made the field. Have you noticed this year that FAU, the four, you know, the Final Four team from last year, who, by the way, I want to remind everyone, was winning that game, leading that game when the clock said zero. Have you noticed there's been treatment's been different this year if you guys have arrived and traveled?
Absolutely. So, first off, just from a pure travel standpoint, I mean, these guys have been getting pictures taken at airports all year long. We still don't fly charter. Most of the teams in the country fly charter. Yep. Certainly ranked teams, we still fly commercial. So these guys are getting autographs asked of them and photographs. That's been a huge difference. Everybody, if you follow basketball, you know who these guys are. Also, too, where everybody's Super Bowl. Everywhere we go, it's their white out or their blue out or their red out and sellout crowds and people storming the. I never thought I'd see the day people storm the floor when they beat FAU, and it's happened a couple of times this year.
Think about
that. It's wild. But also, too, I think that now going into the NCAA tournament, and part of the reason we're sitting there 12-15 with the number one crew there in Brooklyn, it helps UConn and Duke are playing as well. But we're added in there as one of those superstar attractions because of. We went to a new conference this year, and the three most highest-rated games of the season in the American Athletic Conference were all FAU games, FAU-Arizona, FAU-Memphis. I mean, FAU draws eyeballs. And so the fact that we come in this year, and I think so. I think, too, Josh, you remember last year FAU had 31 wins going into the tournament. Mm-hmm. They were Conference USA champs, tournament champions. And you, like you said, it was just sort of, hey, look at these young guys. They're going to get bounced quickly.
Yep.
FAU, Florida Atlantic, playing where they play and what they've been for so long, an at-large eight seed, that's respect. From a selection committee right there. Yep. And I think that's the biggest. FAU is a household name now in college basketball.
You just wonder, you know, first of all, if you've got the number one broadcast team, if you've got the Iron Eagle, Grant Hill, Bill Rafferty team, and they're calling your game, that speaks huge, obviously.
Yep.
We know that also it's the same regional with UConn, so we get that. But you get the feeling that this FAU team kind of became America's sweethearts last year. That there is this, you know, ultimate underdog sense of a Cinderella story. And we had to remind people, and I was the first one to say, you cannot call them a Cinderella because they had more wins than any other team in the country.
No doubt about it.
You can't be a Cinderella and yet have more wins than any other program in the country. Can't both be true.
But you know how things go, though, too, Josh. As soon as someone sees success, then people want to tear them down. And so a lot of times this year, if FAU would lose a game, it would be, see, there's the frauds. Got lucky last year, the frauds, FAU. So as fun as the run was last year, that many people have been waiting to see FAU turn back into the pumpkin this year to use that Cinderella analogy. And so for FAU, why I feel so good for these guys, whether it's Black Golden, Nellie Davis, B.J. Greenlee, on and on and on down the roster, is that they've heard these fraud allegations all year long, and the ultimate validation is to not win your regular season, not win the conference tournament, and still get in as an eight seed in the NCAA tournament. That, by definition, means that last year was not fraudulent in any way, shape, or form, and this has been sustained.
That's respect. It's what it is. Ken LaVica, voice of FAU Owls. Tomorrow, he'll call his second consecutive NCAA tournament with the FAU Owls, playing Northwestern, tipping off just after noon. And, of course, daily you hear him hosting LaVica, Theo, and Stone. Weekdays, noon to 2 on our ESPN West Palm, ESPN 106.3, and streaming platforms. Ken, I'm going to spring this on you. The situation with Shohei Ohtani, his former now translator, and this gambling fiasco scandal. I'm going to ask you this. I'm putting you on the spot. If it turns out or proves to be that Ohtani was making bets himself, do you believe the league should institute a reverse Jordan and make him go play basketball?
I think that's a phenomenal idea. And
you were there the first time. You were in Chicago back in the 90s. You remember the first time.
Yeah.
It was Jordan had to go basketball to minor league baseball. Should he be sent to play D-League basketball?
I think that absolutely he should. And let's not forget his new wife as you know, is a former pro basketball player in Japan. Uh-huh. So it's not like he can't hoop, I'm sure. I'm sure he's got some sort of ability. But this whole thing, I don't think he was gambling, but also I hope the Ohtani camp knows how suspicious it sounds when one story comes out and then all of a sudden it's, oh, no, this guy was lying and he was actually stealing from Shohei Ohtani.
Yeah.
Like that doesn't play particularly well in my mind or anybody who has a rational brain.
Yeah, I think that goes without saying. Ken Lavica, have a great weekend. We don't want to see you until, I don't know, Monday, because win tomorrow, win on Sunday, and then come back, or will you go? Yeah, we're not going to get ahead of ourselves, but do us a favor, don't come back anytime soon.
Okay, all right, that's the plan.
And that's win or lose. That's win or lose. Doesn't matter. Win or lose, just don't come back for a while, okay?
I'll try not to.
Have a great call. We're proud of you, buddy. Enjoy this. It's special.
No, I appreciate it, JC. C-Cat, I appreciate that. I'm looking forward to it tomorrow. And hopefully we're doing something similar next week, previewing something at FAU.
I hope to God
get
so.
Get lost, dude.
What did he say?
Said get lost. Get lost.
That's Stone LeBanowitz telling his co-host, sidekick, his host, as a matter of fact. Stone works for Ken. Don't forget that, Stone. You work for that.
Trust me, I know, and I love it.
Let's go Stetson, too. We need a couple things to happen here.
Oh, okay. Man, so our guys were saying, man, we believe it. We were in the locker room before we went out to practice today at Barclays, and these guys are like, hey, we believe in Stetson. We believe in Stetson. So they believe in the Stetson Hatters as well.
Ken, didn't we already say goodbye to you? Why are you still talking? Did we already say goodbye?
Bye.
I'm just kidding. I appreciate the story. Thank you, Ken. You have a great call.
All right, guys.
There he is, Ken Lavica, voice of the FAU Owls. The Cinderella? No. The success story of a program that finally got there and got there fast last year. More Gonzaga, I would say, than some flash in the pan type of an out of nowhere unknown Cinderella deal. You can't have the most wins in the country and be a Cinderella story. You can be a Cinderella story by getting to the Final Four, but you got to have a record that is, you know, closer to 500 and found a way to get hot in the conference tournament and get yourself in. Time now, since it is the March Betness, paid in full by Hard Rock Bet. It's time for our Hard Rock Bet Tur Bracket. You've heard of the Elite Eight. Well, we've got the Elite Eight, spelled A-T-E. Today, our round one bracket of eight options, bracket style, are the Styles of Pizza. The number one seed, New York Thin Crust. The number two seed, Chicago-style pizza. The number three seed is Detroit, which is a deep dish. The number four seed, Sicilian. The number five seed is Grandma-style pizza. Then we go to the other side of the bracket. The number six seed, flatbread. The number seven seed is St. Louis-style, otherwise known as a pub pizza, bar pizza. And the number eight seed, bagel. Pizza, bagel. It's our Hard Rock Bet Tur Bracket. The Elite Eight in this March Betness with Hard Rock Bet. Let's begin the first matchup. It is New York Thin, the number one seed, taking on Bagel Pizza. This seems like a blowout to me, C-Cat. This sounds like a 40-point win, New York style.
Yeah, it is, but it's a tough draw. I feel bad for the bagel-style pizza because I think they have a chance against a bunch of the other teams.
Don't be an
8
seed. Don't be an 8 seed.
You're a New York guy. I'm a New York guy. It's kind of easy here.
Stone LeBanowitz, we're going to advance just based on Stone and I because, you know, 2 out of 3 doesn't matter what you say. But I imagine you're on New York Thin as well?
Yeah, blowout.
It's a blowout. New York Thin advances. And then we go to the number 2 seed, Chicago Deep Dish versus the 7 seed. This one's sneaky. Because some people don't realize that pub bar, you know, pizza, pub pizza, St. Louis style, without yeast, kind of a cracker style crust, Chicago deep dish. Some people say that's not pizza, that's a meal, that's eating with a fork and a knife. 2 seed Chicago deep dish, the 7 seed St. Louis. What do you got, C-Ken?
We're not judging
who advances.
Who is best described as a pizza. We're kind of competing to see who is the best
the greatest
tasting
style.
Thing. And I'm going to go with Chicago in this matchup.
I'm with you on that. Stone, could you disagree? I know there's probably some pubs in and around Rio slash Palm City that serve a decent St. Louis-style pizza.
But we're going Chicago deep dish.
Yeah, I'm going to triple lock the Chicago deep dish. Another blowout here.
Third matchup in our Hard Rock Bet bracket. The Elite Eight, or Elite Eaton, of our March Betness with Hard Rock Bet, legal in Florida, is Detroit-style pizza, which I love, versus the number six seed flatbread pizza.
I'm going with flatbread because you can have whatever kind of flatbread you want. You can throw some shrimp on there and some weird little
pizza. You can't do that in a Detroit style?
No, not at all. I'm going flatbread.
You're going versatility. Flatbread pizza, by the way, is one of the greatest scams ever sold to humanity.
They can beat you with the three. They can beat you inside. They hit their free throws. That's why I'm going flatbread.
Flatbread is a scam. You're getting like a cracker. You're literally, it's less food, same money. Where's the enjoyment in flatbread pizza? Detroit style, however, similar in a lot of ways to Chicago. But here's the secret with Detroit style. It is a deep dish. It's a square. You've got the corners where it caramelizes. And so you've got that crispy little crunch, almost like brownie brittle. You didn't realize the caramelization that happens with a Detroit-style deep dish.
Yeah, some say caramelization, some say burnt, and I go with burnt.
Well, no, it's not burnt. It's just you're caramelizing onion and sugar. And I'm going Detroit deep dish on this. Stone, unless there's something Stone, where are you going?
Christian?
I don't want to speak for you.
You mean Christina flatbread? Come on now. It's Detroit. This one's
are you questioning my masculinity?
Yeah,
flatbread pizza?
I absolutely am. I think Detroit style is going to take it and run here.
Flatbread is sold by places that don't have a pizza oven and are afraid to try because they're going to screw up pizza, real pizza. So they're like, let's just put stuff on a cracker. You know what makes pizza on a cracker? Ken LaVica. When his wife's out of town, what does he do? He gets his little sweatpants, cut-off shorts. He puts them in the dryer, heats them up, and then puts them on without underpants.
Yeah, and he invites Christian over
invites Christian over. and he makes little microwave mini pizza on top of crackers in the microwave.
And then they feed it to each other.
Two men that like the finer
things. Num.
These sound like two guys who've never had a buffalo chicken flatbread. Whatever.
I've had a billion buffalo chicken flatbreads. You know what I wish I had every time?
Detroit.
Detroit-style pizza instead. Every single time. Flatbread pizza is like going home with the ugly girl from the bar at the end of the night.
It's you can settle for.
It's better than nothing, but it's all you can get at that point. That's exactly right.
Speak for yourself. Hard
the
goal.
Fourth and final matchup in our Hard Rock Bet, March Betness bracket, the Elite Eight, ATE, Sicilian versus Grandma Pizza. This one's tough. Grandma Pizza, for those that don't know, the sauce goes on top. So the sauce is on top, and there's generally a little grated cheese on top of that. But it's going to be square. It's not going to have the thickness of Sicilian. Sicilian, as you know, can be very spongy, can be very doughy. Sicilian is great. Grandma pizza is great. Grandma pizza, big thing in Long Island, New York. Stone, you go first.
Not a fan of the grandma here. I think Sicilian, I do think this is probably a 9.5 double-digit spread, and I think Sicilian covers it.
Sicilian is a 4 seed facing the 5 seed is a 9-point favorite.
Yeah,
well, I don't know about
that. I mean, that's how low Grandma Pizza sits on the totem pole. So much so that I had to look up what it was.
I was gonna say, I think a lot of people just don't know what Grandma Pizza is.
Right.
I think that's what the issue is.
This CK. You talked about the spread in this game getting close to double digits. The over under in this game is like in the 80s. This is a rock fight. These two pizzas stink. I hate both of them.
You don't like Sicilian pizza?
No.
I'm with you.
Sicilian sitting behind the glass at a New York pizza shop right next to a regular pie. I don't know why anyone would make a conscious decision to go with Sicilian.
If the slice costs the same amount, and it doesn't, but if it did, Sicilian's going to be a half a pound of food. It's going to be 8 ounces plus. It's going to actually be probably 12 ounces.
It's a breadstick with the pizza sauce and cheese on top. I'm going grandma by default.
So we are at 1 vote Sicilian, 1 vote grandma, which means that I get to decide. Yeah, it's not much of an upset. I know Stone said it's a 9-point dog, but Grandma Pizza advances.
Oh.
Grandma Pizza's underrated. You may not know what it is. You may want to Google it and find out. But Grandma Pizza, particularly if the sauce is done grandma style, it's a different style of sauce. And then you've got a little bit of grated cheese on top. The sauce sits on the top. It's a different flavor combination. It's a different order. And yeah, the order in which you taste things does change the way it tastes.
Right.
If you don't believe me, take your peanut butter and jelly sandwich and flip it over. Take one bite this way, then flip it over, try it the other way. Tastes different.
It's a travesty. Grandma got to the final four. Fraud.
Yeah, it is.
So New York Thin now faces the second highest, second lowest rather, and that'd be Grandma. New York Thin versus Grandma Pizza. Stone.
New York Thin here, no contest here. Grandma actually didn't even show up to the court for tip-off.
Grandma Pizza now takes on the number three seed, Detroit style. Stone. I'm sorry, C-Cat.
You said Grandma versus Detroit?
No. Okay. It's Detroit. I'm sorry. Chicago versus Detroit. Ooh. Chicago versus Detroit. Yeah, we're at the Final Four now.
I'm with Chicago here. Again, I don't care if you don't consider it pizza. It is delicious, and I've yet to have the very best. I've never been in Chicago and had Chicago style.
It is delicious. It is nutritious. You sound like Michael Scott making breakfast for Pam. pancakes, free pancake dinner in the parking lot at Dunder Mifflin. Stone, one vote Chicago.
Let's go two votes Chicago here.
Yeah, let's go three votes. Detroit is great. Walmart actually sells a great frozen Detroit, Motor City Pizza Company is what it's called. It's like a $7 frozen pizza in a tray. Dude, it's tremendous.
I have a problem with frozen pizzas.
This one, if you make it right, I'm telling you, it's tremendous.
But you know I am.
For $7.67.
With the deals and not liking to cook at home, I'll find deals where you're paying the same amount of money at some pizza joints for the ready-made pizza. So I go away from the frozen, go to the chain spot instead.
Thank you very much, Tom. I mean, Christian. The Detroit pizza, like I said, is less than $8. You're going to get that style in a joint. It's going to be $25.
You got the wrong joints, pal. My joints?
For a full Detroit style, you're not paying $8.
I digress. Let's get it.
Show me, and I'll buy it.
Okay, yeah.
Chicago advances. We are exactly where we thought we would be. It's New York Thin versus Chicago Deep Dish. This is the greater, not the more popular. This is not what the people think. This is who you believe is actually the greater in our Hard Rock Bet. March Betness. Elite 8. ATE. Meeting it. We're eating this. It's food related. New York style. Chicago style. C-Cat.
You use the word great, so it's all encompassing. It's not just taste. I love the portability of a New York slice. You can go to the Dollar Slice in Manhattan, take it and walk it with you on the way to work.
The portability.
I'm with New York all the way.
Because you're so busy. You have so many places to be.
Uh-huh. That one summer I interned in New York City, of course, I have places
you're
to be.
You're so busy. You're so busy with your life.
Got to eat on the run.
How many hours do they even let you work a day here?
No comment.
but you're not as busy as you want to be.
Yeah. That's...
Well, at least you'll have time now to walk around with your pizza. So congratulations on that. I'm going Chicago Deep Dish. I am a native New Yorker, and I know five great places in the city to get a dollar slice. But with that said, Chicago Deep Dish with a buttery, flaky, pastry-style crust with the sauce on top, with the meats and just gooey cheeses that kind of stretch and spew and leak out of Chicago Deep Dish pizza. I'm going Chicago Deep Dish. Stone, I can't believe it, but you get to be the deciding vote.
And still New York.
You can't go wrong.
No, you cannot, sir. No. The price. Everything Christian said was spot on, my friend.
You can't go wrong with New York style pizza.
Got to eat on the go. We're busy guys, me and C-Cat.
There's a reason why it's the one that's the most popular style of pizza.
Right.
But C-Cat's got plenty of time. C-Cat's got time to bake a deep dish pizza. Chicago style, let alone walk around with it.
What's the saying? Often replicated, never duplicated. I'm often imitated, never duplicated.
Who imitates
New York
you?
Style. Not I'm talking about New York pizza. In the fact, there's so many people that try New York pizza,
of course,
and they can't quite get it. Not many people even try Chicago pizza. They're going with New York because they want to be the greatest.
Chicago deep dish pizza is very complicated to make. It's very complicated to make. It's very time consuming and costly to actually make. There it is. Our first round, March Betness, Hard Rock Better Bracket, Pizza Styles in our Elite Eight. No surprises, no upset, really. The only upset we had was, I think, Graham over Sicilian, right? A 5-4.
Yeah.
We come back. C-Cat's going to give us an update on the tournament, where we stand at this hour. Plus, 12 seed McNeese State, who played tonight against Gonzaga. They're a 6.5-point dog at 7:25. McNeese State may have scheduled a game against whom? We will reveal that when we come back. First, though, I mentioned Hard Rock Bet a bajillion times. They're why we're here. They're where we are. Hard Rock Bet, in case you didn't know. And I'm looking at the counter right now. This is crazy. You've got people that are lined up to place bets in person. In person. Or they already placed their bets and they're going to cash those tickets. Either way, you love to see it. You can have the app on your phone. It's like having a sports book in your pocket. You can have it on your tablet, whatever you got. Hard Rock Bet, the only legal sports book in Florida. And by the way, you can sign up in minutes. Easy to sign up. Faster with to withdraw. Faster to deposit money in. Use PayPal, Venmo, credit cards, and more. Live wager, parlay. Live wager parlay, meaning that a game is already going on. You don't like the way it's going, or you think that you see something that's going to lead to, you can bet it in the middle of the game or toward the end of the game. Everything from the over-unders through, of course, winning outright, through, of course, the point spreads as they vary. Easy to sign up, fast to deposit, fast to withdraw. I withdraw money on the regular immediately, send Venmos right back, bang, 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 to my bank. I love Hard Rock Bet. And by the way, your bracket's going to break. Your bracket's going to be broken. You got a whole tournament to go. That's why you want to be on Hard Rock Bet so you can play the games as you go. And remember, on Hard Rock Bet, your first bet is unbustable, unlike your bracket. If you don't win, you get up to $100 back as a bonus bet to try again. Meaning that if your first bet, whatever the amount is, up to $100, if it doesn't win, you get a bonus bet back in that same amount, up to $100, to, as I said, try again. Download it from the App Store. Download Hard Rock Bet. Now, from Google Play Store or at hardrock.bet. Offered by the Seminole Tribe of Florida, must be 21 plus. Physically present in Florida to wager. Terms and conditions apply. If you're concerned about gambling, call 888-ADMIT-IT. We're back live in moments from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino and the Hard Rock Bet Sportsbook and Sports Bar. Home team on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3.
What you drive says a lot about you. And if what you're driving has the Ed Morse name on it, it says you expect a lot from your vehicle and even more from the people you bought it from. You see, at Ed Morse, we don't just sell vehicles, we stand behind them. And behind each and every one of the more than 2 million people who drive them. That's why we've been in business since 1946 and why every person who drives off our lot is backed by Morse.
Ed Morse proudly supports the Miami Dolphins. Make sure your next vehicle is backed by Morse. Visit edmorse.com today.
Time now for a PNC pause. PNC Bank is committed to helping the customers and the communities they serve move forward financially. See how they can make a difference for you at PNC.com.
Prescriptions require an online consultation with a healthcare provider who will determine if appropriate restrictions apply. See website for details and important safety information. Subscription required. Price varies based on product and subscription plan.
Hey guys, did you know there's a generic form of Viagra that works just the same but is 95% cheaper? And you can get it online at hims.com/joy. Through Hims, you'll get a free medical consultation to determine the ED medication that's best for you. Discreet shipping if prescribed, a 100% online process, and a range of treatment options, including trusted generic alternatives to the name brands, at up to 95% off. ED is personal, and at Hims, so is treating it. Just go to hims.com/joy and get connected to a licensed medical provider online for free. With zero copay, no expensive appointments, and no awkward face-to-face conversations. To start your free online visit, you need to go to this exclusive address, hims.com/joy. That's hims.com/joy for your free online visit, hims.com/joy.
You're listening to ESPN 106.3, presented by Rubenstein Law. 1-800-FL-LEGAL. Car accident, truck accident, Uber or Lyft accident, or slip and fall? Call Rubenstein Law. Call 1-800-FL-LEGAL and visit one of our offices throughout Florida.
Want to accelerate your career as a manager or executive in the exciting industry of sports? FAU's MBA program in sport management is ranked number one in Florida, 10th in the world. Students learn practical and applied skills from top faculty and experts who work in the industry. The full-time MBA program sets students up for success in the world of sports. Check out FAU Sport Management MBA program today, fau.edu/MBA sport.
The college basketball championship is back. From every big play to all the buzzer beaters, Sam Adams and Twisted Tea has you covered with every sip. Join ESPN West Palm Friday, March 22nd from 2:30 to 4:30 p.m. at Hurricanes and Stewart for your chance to win big. Compete in a basketball challenge while enjoying $2 off Sam's Seasonal and Twisted Tea. Must be 21+. Brought to you by J.J. Taylor, who reminds you to drink responsibly.
Thank you for listening to ESPN 106.3. I love you. Thank you for listening to ESPN 106.3. I love you. Thank you for listening to ESPN 106.3. I love you.
It's lights out in Miami. The 2024 Formula One Crypto.com Miami Grand Prix takes off May 3rd through the 5th. The three-day event is filled with art, music, world-class cuisine, and, of course, top-notch racing. Tickets are available now. Choose from a variety of grandstands, each with a fantastic track view that puts you right in the center of the action and gives you access to the full campus. Visit F1MiamiGP.com. That's F1MiamiGP.com today.
ESPN 106.3. This is Josh Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sportsbook. This is ESPN 106.3.
Home Team on the road, live from Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, the physical site. That is the Hard Rock Bet. You can have the app. You can have the sports book in your pocket with you 24/7. You can also come here and bet in person with real live people. Get a ticket. Go inside the Hard Rock sports book, which functions as a sport. And by the way, you see that there's machines?
Mm-hmm. Kiosks, if you will.
Yeah, if you will. What you drive, it says a lot about you. And if what you drive has the Ed Morse name on it, it says you expect a lot from your vehicle. It says you should expect also a lot from the people that sold you the vehicle. Ed Morse doesn't just sell cars and trucks and SUVs. Stand behind them. And behind each and every one of the more than 2 million people who drive Ed Morse vehicles. That's why the family-owned and operated Ed Morse Automotive Group of dealerships has been in business since 1946, 78 years now. Dedication to customers, dedication to community. When Ed Morse says they got your back, trust me, you believe them. You are backed by Morse. Ed Morse proudly supports the Miami Dolphins, our veterans, military, lots of tremendous charitable efforts. Make sure your next vehicle is backed by Morse. Visit edmorse.com today, edmorse.com, because you're always backed by Morse. Let's get a update on this March betness in the NCAA tournament. C-Cat, let's get an update right now from you as to where we are. You play the tournament music on this, Stoney. Thank you very much. And by the way, this update being presented by Anajar and Levine, Accident Attorneys. See Cat.
First game of the day, 9-seed Michigan State beats 8-seed Mississippi State 69-51. This game is kind of out of hand early. Spartans took it to the Bulldogs.
First upset, though, 9-8.
Second upset of the day, Duquesne, 11-seed, beats 6-seed BYU 71-67. That was really the game of the day so far. A lot of blowouts mixed in the early games on day one of round number one. Blowout here, 3-seed Creighton beats 14-seed Akron 77-60. The Zips kept it close for a while there, but not long enough. 2-seed Arizona takes down 15-seed Long Beach 85-65. That game was also close at half, but
Long Beach State, who, by the way, covered on Hard Rock Bet, they were getting 20.5 points. They lost by 20.
That's what matters if you're on the spread.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's by how much.
Another blowout here. 1-seed UNC starts off on the right track this tournament. They beat 16-seed Wagner 90-62. And then you have Illinois. That one just went final. 3-seed Illinois beats 14-seed Florida State 85-69. A couple games in action still. 63-50, 11-seed Oregon leading over 6-seed South Carolina. That game has 9:30 left in the game at halftime.
Well, that's significant. That's significant because that's one of those 11 seeds that I talked about, an 11 seed that I had advancing. A 13-point lead with 9:29 remaining. 13 points is about the danger zone inside of 10 minutes for a South Carolina team or really anybody. Now that lead is now 11, 63-52. So keep an eye on that one. You think up 11 inside of 10 minutes is safe. No, no lead is safe in the NCAA tournament. All right, C-Cat, thank you very much. The update being presented by Anajar and Levine, Accident Attorneys. Car accidents, truck accidents, slip and fall, trip and fall, injured on the job. Workers' comp issues? Call Anna John Levine, accident attorneys. Consultation's absolutely free. They will fight for you. They'll fight to get you the maximum compensation that you deserve. And remember, they do not get paid unless you get paid. And you'll always talk about your case with an actual attorney. Call 1-800-747-FREE. 1-800-747-FREE. 800-747-3733. My friends, Mark Anajar, Glenn Levine, and a big team of litigators to help you take back control of your life. Real quick, McNeese State taking on Gonzaga tonight, 7:25 p.m. The Zags, a 6.5-point favorite in the oftentimes tumultuous 12-5 matchup. McNeese State, take a listen to whom it is they actually scheduled a game with. This courtesy of our friends at Pardon My Take on Barstool. Listen.
McNeese State non-conference schedule. I don't know if you guys took a look at this. They beat Biblical Studies 96-55. They beat Champion Christian 110-46. They beat a school called Le Tournay, so French. They beat a French school 81-49. And the big one that they absolutely dominated, they won a game 92-23 against Mississippi University for Women.
Oh, I love that. They have a men's team?
Yeah.
That was true. 92-23 over the Mississippi School for Women. Did they beat a women's team? No. No. It was a men's team. They, several years ago, added men to the university and men's programs. But it sounds funny.
Yeah.
And by the way, they called the university, they call themselves the Dub. The W. The Dub. And so I guess the big recruiting pitch is, dude, there's lots of women here at this university.
Got to change the school name once you're allowing fellas in.
I don't think you do. No, I don't think you do. But good on McNeese State. By the way, 12-5 used to be the big upset. Used to be the big slot. Recent years, not the case. Last year didn't get a single as well. So this might be the year that a 12 surprised the 5. And what irony would be if the, you know, for the better part of the late 90s and early 2000s, Gonzaga getting there became the victim themselves of a 12 beating them.
So do you think it is just coincidence or that if there's a steep drop-off where the difference between the 20th best team in the country is not much better than the 48th best team? Talking about if you rank all the teams 1 through 64, yeah, the difference between those bottom half really isn't that much.
It's not that big.
Yeah, and right. That's what you see with that.
That's what it seems to be. All right, coming up when we return, we enter the two-minute warning, our Twitter debate poll results, and the championship of cringe, Dad Joke Daily. C-Cat with a comedy spotlight that he wants all to himself. And you can understand why. He's killing it like that. St. Lucie Battery and Tire remains the home of honest, reliable service since 1970. St. Lucie Battery and Tire is a man who's clapping. Big fan of St. Lucie Battery and Tire. 17 locations, West Palm through the Treasure Coast. There's a difference. If you love America, if you love what this country is about, you will love St. Lucie Battery and Tire. A family-owned business taking care of the communities that they serve with integrity. There's accountability when you're a family-owned business because you're representing the family name, and that's why you take care of people, and therefore you do right by them. If you need oil changes, they can get you in and out faster and cheaper than a dealership can. If you need batteries, they got batteries for not just cars and trucks and RVs, but they got batteries for golf carts, side-by-sides, ATVs, everything. Go to slbt.com or just stop by because St. Lucie Battery and Tire is the home of honest, reliable service since 1970. We're back in moments for the two-minute warning. Live from Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, it is March Betness on the home team on ESPN 106.3.
Live from the Anajar and Levine Accident Attorney Studios. Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys. Call 1-800-747-FREE. This is ESPN 106.3.
Hey, it's Josh Cohen from the home team. Let's play a little game of question and answer. Who has the largest fleet of luxury vehicles in South Florida? A1A Limo. Who offers an on-time guarantee or your money back? A1A Limo. And whose drivers are background checked and average over 5 years of continuous service? A1A Limo. That's who. Whether it's for business or personal, from airport runs to nights on the town to games or concerts, A1A Limo is always the smart choice. Book now at A1ALimo.com. That's A1ALimo.com.
International Diamond Center's values are so compelling, it's not unusual to see people here that are not local.
Every day, we have people that drive an hour and a half, even 2 hours.
IDC owner Keith LeClaire.
People are willing to drive because they've heard it's not a typical jewelry store.
For example, did you know IDC has one of the largest selections of luxury pre-owned Rolexes in America? Thousands of hard-to-find Rolex watches, Submariners, Daytonas, Pepsis, Batmans, all in perfect condition.
We scour the world to find only the most pristine, super clean watches. We only carry the creme de la creme.
And like everything else at IDC, these watches are at a price that's guaranteed to give you maximum value.
We price them to win the customer, not lose a customer.
International Diamond Center. For pre-owned Rolexes, exquisite rare diamonds, premium designer jewelry, and exceptional white glove service.
You're going to want to come to IDC. It's worth the drive.
International Diamond Center, US 1 and PSL Boulevard, and online at shopidc.com.
Whether it's a clutch touchdown pass, a game-winning dunk, or a dash to the finish, we want to highlight the best performance of the week presented by Baptist Health South Florida. Every week, different teams will be highlighted across ESPN 106.3 and ESPN West Palm Play. The winning performance receives $500 courtesy of Baptist Health South Florida. Know of a team, player, or school with a killer performance? Nominate them today by emailing highschool@espnwestpalm.com. Baptist Health Orthopedic Care. Go where the pros go.
ESPN 106.3. Cohen and the Home Team, streaming live worldwide on YouTube on ESPN West Palm Play. Presented by Hard Rock Bet, Florida's official sportsbook. This is ESPN 106.3.
Back with you one more time inside the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino. And just across from the actual in-person counters and tellers, that is Hard Rock Bet. You can bet with human beings on sports or use the kiosk machines. And better yet, just download the app from the Apple App Store or your Google Play Store or at hardrock.bet. But do that, please. C-Cat's got a reminder about an event coming up this weekend with the games as well.
Hey, the tourney's here. ESPN West Palm, they're teaming up with Sam Adams and Twisted Tea for your all your tournament action.
Twisted Tea.
Join us tomorrow, Friday, March 22nd, from 2:30 to 4:30, right in the swing of things at Hurricanes in Stewart. Give your best shot at these basketball games. We have to win prizes. Drink specials all month long, including $2 off Sam's Seasonal and Twisted Tea. Must be 21+. J.J. Taylor reminds you to please drink responsibly.
Real quick, to check our on-air Twitter debate poll results on my Twitter at JoshOnAir, who do you believe was actually doing the betting? A, Shohei Ohtani himself, or B, Miss O'Hara, the interpreter? 60% said Ohtani.
They want it to be Ohtani.
They believe. Next question. Which do you believe is actually the truth? A, Ohtani made the payments to the bookie, or B, Mitsuhara, the interpreter, stole the money? 67% believe Ohtani paid it.
Wow. It's benefit of the doubt. Ohtani has not been shady in the past, so it can give him off the hook a little bit.
Time for Dad Joke Daily, the championship of cringe. C-Cat goes uncontested with the comedy spotlight. Go ahead, C-Cat. The music is playing, I believe. Go ahead, C-Cat, take it.
Why is the basketball arena hot after the game?
Because the Miami Heat played there.
Ooh, close. All the fans have left.
Fans.
Uh-huh.
Got it.
What do you call a monkey that wins back-to-back NCAA titles?
I don't know what.
A champion. Kingdom Planet of the Apes coming out soon. Excited for it. How about this one?
Excited for it.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Yeah.
Last one.
What do you call when you drive quickly through the Miami Hurricanes campus?
I don't know what.
An undergraduate degree. Not going to make some listeners happy.
I don't get that.
They just throw the degree into your car because it's so worthless.
You're worthless.
I know.
That's what they couldn't find. Hey, thank you, Stone Lubanowitz, back in studio. Thank you, Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino, for having us. Hard Rock Bet for having us. Remember, download the app immediately. Play these games within 5 minutes. Literally. Coming up next, it's ESPN West Palm tonight, 7 to midnight, plus the NCAA tournament coverage. Love those games for you. And we're off tomorrow to air the games all day as well. Every day above ground.
It's a good day.
Say goodnight to the bad guy.
Good night, bad guy.
Have a great night. Home team time, 6 p.m.
Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys, call 1-800-747-3. This is ESPN 106.3 WUUB Jupiter, a Good Karma Brands radio station.
My day just flows better when I make my first stop McDonald's. I can choose two of my faves and save big when I bundle a savory sausage McMuffin or flaky sausage biscuit with crispy hash browns for breakfast for $2.89. Or I can make Mickey D's my last stop. Lunch, dinner, a late night snack, perhaps. When I bundle a hot and spicy McChicken or juicy McDouble with delicious